Econophysics is the attempt to apply concepts from physics to financial markets or to problems in economy in general. And why is it an advantage to use these ideas, which comes from a discipline which is mainly handling natural science questions? And the answer is that we are able to understand very, very complex systems using approaches from physics. And to give you one example, we are dealing with complex systems in terms of multi-particle systems. We try to understand what are the interactions between one atom and the next atom. And that's very similar to a system, to complex systems like financial markets. And there, different traders are interacting with each other based on the order flow they are generating. And financial markets are the prime example for complex systems research. And complex systems research, it's not only involving physics, it's also involving mathematics, informatics, everything ICT, so information communication technology. It's a prime example for this kind of complex systems research, as for no other system so huge amount of data is available. And so a lot of people started to use this to try to transfer concepts from physics to financial markets. And there are examples that this was really helpful. And it's actually all about the question, what's the way how we can describe this very complex system in a more appropriate fashion? If we think of traditional economics, they assume general equilibrium, and obviously crashes and bubbles cannot occur. It has nothing to do with the real world. So we are actually observing these kinds of extreme events in the market. And so more and more appropriate approaches are necessary to, yeah, to describe these phenomena in a very efficient and correct way. And the tools, the tools come from the complex systems research. And there, physics is one of the leading disciplines. And physics has demonstrated that for many other kind of research problems, these complex approaches are very useful. First of all, there's a difference between the economics understanding. So in economics, they like to start with a model. They have some assumptions. They build a model, and then they can derive some implications out of these assumptions. But the approach in physics is a very different one. Because in physics, people are familiar with experiments, and so they collect as much as possible data. That's the first part. And then they try to understand what's in the data. They don't neglect outliers. That's a problem in economics. They assume price changes are just as a Gaussian distribution, but that's not the case, obviously. We have these fat-tailed price distributions with the power law decay. And so people in physics start with the data. And so they try to understand it based on empirical laws they were able to uncover, or they are uncovering. It's a very hot and active research field. And then the next step is to model these empirical findings. And so it's a different approach to start with the data or to start with the model. And so we can think about what's the better way.